Kanye West didn't deliver the best gospel album of the year, this lady did. Of course, to call it a gospel album would be simplifying. This is conceptual avant-garde jazz with vocal parts. I've seen from music reviewers only The Needle Dropped reviewed this, which is strange given how good it is. I think he liked it, but I don't really trust that much the nerdy reviewers with indie rock background when they offer takes on spiritual jazz. This is such a specific genre. I think this is the real core and heart of jazz. At some point, all the greatest African-American musicians wanted to discover their African traditions, origins, and incorporate them to their music. So this is as true as one gets. And what helped me understand it, feel it, was the death of someone. In 97, Fela Kuti had the bad luck of dying, and the Polish radio played a lot of his music, which affected my preferences in later years, and helped develop my fondness for spiritual jazz later on. I fully embraced jazz as my favorite genre. So what's that good about the Matana Roberts album Coin Chapter 4 Memphis? First off, the depth of the sound. This is the first thing you hear. You can hear all the layers. The production of this is very good. And then you hear how she used the traditional work songs of African-American community, as well as the use of fiddle and accordion as instruments. I've listened to some original music from the 20s of previous century, and I think this one, while sounding very modern, does a good job transferring back in time to that time. I think the best moments here are the vocal conclusions of the instrumental parts. And my jaw officially dropped when I heard Her Mighty Waters Run, which is also a take on a traditional song. At that moment I knew I'm listening to my favorite album of the year. When the album finishes, you realize that you are a witness of a musical journey brought to you through a concept with sound and narration. Matana Roberts is a storyteller here. She's telling a story of young girl from her family, reportedly, the story that she heard from her grandmother. Matana did a lot of research generally about Memphis. She did interviews, she moved there for a while and searched through the archives, looking for stories. She's trying to get into the shoes of the characters she's portraying and tell their story. You know, in sociology, there is a phenomenon that the grandchildren of the traumatized generations feel the need of telling their grandparents' story. The same phenomenon happens in different parts of the world. It can be as much about Holocaust or as about slave trade or general racism experience, or like totalitarian regime experiences in Europe or in South America, for example. It's like an internal obligation, it's like you owe something to the previous generations. And the US, you know, this is a country with decades of racism. That now they are trying to cover up with extra woke attitude. It's sometimes directed in some bad directions, like barking the wrong tree, really. Because, for example, like the Twitter warriors only can see people, judge people by their skin colors. But the truth is, well, I'm Polish, and Polish people are typically seen as basically physical labor. So in this progressive, inclusive countries of Western Europe, I mean, I live in Norway, I see enough. So so it's not like somebody would tell me, oh, you're Polish, so you're white, let's be privileged together. It's more like, oh, you're Polish, you can clean my house, this is what you're good for. Well, but fortunately here I am, smart and funny and with refined musical taste, to help debunk all the stereotypes. No, seriously, even this Polish woman who recently received the Nobel Prize in Literature used to work as a maid in England, so... But okay, back to Matana. Coin isn't her only project, but this is her beloved project, and, you know, the most important thing in her life. Let me quote this from the Bandcamp article. Maybe because it's so rooted in my bloodline, the series feels like a beacon, some place I'm able to go back into and know that I'm home and I'm welcome there. It's my blanket and universe, and I feel some sense of love in that work that I don't get from any of the other work that I make. You can feel that something is truly special for an artist, that it comes straight from their heart. And this is a problem that I have with modern jazz albums. I simply don't feel the same thing. That's why this one is also special for me as a listener. So, you know, I'm happy this is the album that transfers us back to the 20s of the current century. I hope the decade will be better than the one we had 100 years ago. That we'll just pass the exam as human race, and that we'll have more musical projects as good as this one here. So yes, this is my album of the year, and I'll see you next time reviewing something else. Take care!